Hi, my name's Amanda. So my background is beauty therapy and massage therapy. So a little bit about me, I've been working in the beauty industry for about 20 years. So I've really, over the years, probably gravitated more towards the health side of beauty. So massage, skincare treatments, and especially organic, natural skincare. So I'm just going to share some of the knowledge, some of my knowledge and what I've learned about the benefits of massage, body treatments and skincare over the years. So, and also throughout the different stages in life, and also show you some practical techniques that you can use at home that are time consuming. So these days it's super important for women to take care of themselves, especially with the high demands of work and motherhood. And it's vital that we look after ourselves. So massage is a wonderful way to do this. It promotes relaxation and it has a number of benefits to the mind and body. So a lot of people believe that it's a luxury, but it's actually got some amazing health benefits. So some of these are, it helps to reduce muscle aches and pains, relieve some postural stress. So if you're sitting in front of a computer all day, a lot of people have problems with sore shoulders and neck, so it can really help with that. It also eases muscle pain by improving blood circulation. So circulation is really important for the body to help transport oxygen and nutrients to the cells of the body. So massage is a fantastic way to help with that. It also reduces stress and anxiety and also depression. So it can be incredibly therapeutic and relaxing. So studies have also found that it can help women going through cancer, especially breast cancer. So it actually helps with the anxiety and stress and depression with that, and it also improves sleep and boosts immunity. So during pregnancy, massage has some amazing benefits. So it can improve relaxation, lowering stress and anxiety, relieve lower back pain and hip pain in women who are experiencing that. So it can also help to prepare your body for birth and labour, relieve pain during labour, and also helps with restless legs by improving the blood circulation. It helps with edema and swelling in the hands and feet and legs as well. So essential oils can be incorporated into massage treatments as well. They have some amazing health benefits. So there's lots of different blends for relaxation, uplifting, and also for support as well. So this leads me on to talk about natural organic skincare products and why the ingredients are so important to our health. So our bodies absorb what we put onto our skin, so it's really important that we're not putting lots of chemicals and toxins into our system through our skin. So this can harm our health over time and become very toxic. So some of the main ones that I usually tell people about, and one of the really nasty ones is parabens in skincare products. So it can get very, very confusing, especially when products have, a whole list of ingredients and chemicals and different things that you haven't heard of. But parabens are used as preservatives in skincare products. So scientific studies have suggested that they can disrupt like hormones and affect fertility and reproduction. Sodium lauryl sulfate is another one as well. Petroleum formaldehyde, which is found in some nail polishes and nail products. So artificial fragrances and colours have also been linked to hormone disruption and breast cancer. So I always say the safest skincare is natural and organic. So you can't go wrong. Organic means that the ingredients come from certified organic farmers, which means that there's no manufactured pesticides, herbicides, preservatives, sulfites, parabens, and synthetic colours and fragrances. There's also no growth hormones, and the farming methods should take care of sustainable land management as well, so that's really important. And they're usually plant-based. Organic ingredients are higher, have sort of a higher quality as well because of the way they're grown and farmed. So they have a lot of nutrients which are going to be more active and nourishing to the skin as well. So there's a few sort of practical home self-care techniques that you can do yourself, which aren't very time consuming. So there's a couple that I swear by, and one of them is massage. So face massage is something that you can do yourself. Obviously, it's, to get the full benefits, it's nice to go and have, you know, a professional massage with a massage therapist or beauty therapist. But there's a few little things that you can do at home yourself. So a quick and easy face massage is always lovely, and you can do this morning or at night whenever you've got time to do it. And this just helps to stimulate the circulation in your skin. It can help with anti-aging. It can help to oxygenate your skin by stimulating the circulation, and also, so therefore, you'll have more nutrients going to your skin. So the best way to do it is with a little bit of oil or even your moisturizer at home at night. So I can do a little demonstration if you like. So the best way to start is like on the décolletage area or the neck, and you can just work your way up. It's a little bit tricky because I don't have any oil on my hands, but yeah, just always going in an upwards direction, because as you age as well, your skin can lose collagen and elastin and become a little bit looser and saggy. So you can actually just use your fingers to go in an upward movement, massaging around the eyes and the pressure points. So this is really relaxing around the eyes, holding at the pressure points, and on your forehead, massaging in an upwards direction. And then you can come back down and just do this a few times. So going up from the décolletage and circular movements around the eyes. I always find it's easy to do it on somebody else than yourself. But
you're looking good.
So if you just repeat those steps a few times, then that really, really, really helps to, it's very, very simple. It's not, 10 steps that you need to try and memorize and remember. Okay, so then the next thing that I swear by every morning before I shower, and it only takes, about 5 minutes of your time, and it's dry body brushing. So this is actually a wonderful massage technique, and it also has great benefits for the skin as well. So these little brushes here, you can actually get them from Woolies, quite cheap, and they've just got the perfect bristles to do that for. So the reason that dry body brushing is so effective and better for your skin is you're doing it while your skin is actually dry. So if you're, that's the difference between doing the dry compared to the exfoliating in the shower. So if you're exfoliating in the shower, that can remove all of the oil, like the natural oils from your skin, and end up drying your skin out. So this usually takes about 5 minutes. So you start with your feet. So this is excellent for stimulating the circulation as well. So it's a combined exfoliation massage treatment. So usually you start from the feet and just work up, work your way up the legs with long flowing movements. Right from the feet. So, can't really demonstrate. I've got points.
Would you demonstrate on me?
Okay? Absolutely.
Yeah. Do you want me to sit?
You want to sit?
That's it.
You want to be down? Yeah. Sitting is fine. Okay. Yeah. Normally you would have somebody on laying on the bed. So,
sorry, I might have shared the looks for a while.
Who does these days?
From the feet. And
oh, that's nice.
Yeah, and it's
just really invigorating.
Yeah.
Feeling as well. So this is really great.
So I do this before I turn the water on.
Yeah. So yep. Do this before you hop in the shower. Mm-hmm. So you're removing the dry skin before you hop in the shower. So it's great in winter as well, just to remove, because you get a lot of dry skin in winter.
And do I do this instead of an exfoliation, or do this before an exfoliation?
I would do it instead. Yeah, because it's going to be removing the dry skin.
That's even better. One less product.
Yeah.
That's great.
It's actually good for detoxifying your body as well. So working in upward movements, circular movements around the torso, and then you can start up the hands and work up the arms as well. So,
how often in a week should I do that?
Every day. You can do it every day. So if you've got sort of sensitive or thin skin, you just need to go a little bit more gentle. So, yeah.
Lovely.
I know
what I'm getting.
Yeah.
That's great.
And these ones from Woolworths actually come with the long handle as well, which you can use for your back.
I love the timber look on them too.
Yeah.
They look great.
Yeah. So that's one of the little beauty techniques that I swear by.
Perfect.
And it's got a huge...
And it's just before you hop in the shower anyway, so it's very convenient.
Yeah, so great for stimulating the circulation, removing dry skin cells, and also detoxifying the body as well.
Perfect.
I think that's all. Yeah, so we talked about the face massage and the... dry body brushes, and yeah, if there's any questions or anyone would like to know anything else.
Got a few about the pregnancy and the massaging.
Absolutely.
So obviously I get the really bad lower back pain, but I get really bad varicose veins in my legs because of obviously all the pressure. Is there a massage to sort of help relieve that getting worse or not particularly?
Yeah, so any massage is going to help stimulate the circulation and detoxify the body.
Mm-hmm.
And with the fluid, massage helps with fluid retention as well. So, that would also help to, just help circulate the blood around the body so that it's not building up.
Yeah. And would most massage places massage a pregnant lady, or should I go to somewhere particular?
I would definitely go somewhere who has a little bit more knowledge in pregnancy massage, just so that they understand the conditions throughout pregnancy as well. So pregnancy massage is very safe, but if you do have any concerns, like there are a few.
Is every therapist trained in pregnancy massage, or is that something that you do additionally as a separate?
Usually course? Something you do additionally, yeah. So if you have a diploma in beauty therapy or a diploma in remedial massage, I think they do touch on pregnancy massage a little bit, but definitely someone who has specialised.
So Miss Reflexology.
At least like a certificate in pregnancy massage.
Yep. Perfect.
Yeah.
Beautiful. Perfect.